ESPN in Mexico and Costa Rica, but they will have 7 added minutes, we understand. So we'll be here on ESPN 2, and that match will hear that we're about to start. We'll move over when events permit. Panama sitting with 6 points. The top 3 nations in CONCACAF go through, but Mexico have played that extra game. And all of this tonight, an important night in CONCACAF, we'll get a sense of who the big dogs on the block are. Right now, Mexico, they've got a lot of questions to answer.
Absolutely. Uninspired play by Mexico. We got it going out of the corner of our eye here, the game. I mean, the reality is that this is not a team that has been talked about over the last couple of years of the golden generation. This is not a team that everybody talked about the gap between Mexico and the U.S. There's no gap right now here. They have got to get it together. They can't score. They can't even score in Azteca.
Well, there was always a fear of every team going to Azteca, and right now, nobody can score. They can't score in their own stadium.
And a moment they've waited a long time here for Seattle to see their national team in a World Cup qualifier. And again, a temporary sod field. 3 points at stake, and the United States coming in a position of strength off the 3 on the road in stoppage time. Jurgen Klinsmann talked about the great teams don't hit the off button. They don't give a moment rest. He thought his team did that, and they conceded an 89th-minute goal on Friday night.
Well, the fact is, for the U.S., they play the underdog role very, very well. They've done it for years. They're very comfortable in it. This game here tonight, coming up against Panama. Individually, the U.S. is better than Panama. Collectively, as a team, they are better than Panama. But just saying it doesn't get them the win. They have to come out. They have to recognize that they're better than the team, but they have to come out. They're going to get possession. I think Panama's going to pull back and try to absorb some pressure and try to counter. They have to be smart in the way that they play. When they get their opportunities, finish this team off and get this 3 points.
Exactly. Win your home games and you qualify for a World Cup. Simple as that. You've got the points on the road in the bag. Now do the job at home.
And they won, of course, Friday night, the United States taking the lead on the Altidore goal. And then what a moment for Brad Evans, who plays with the Sounders, bringing his national team home to Seattle on the strength of a stoppage time goal 92 minutes into that match on Friday evening. What a moment. Out of the picture, not even the periphery. And now a hero from Friday night and playing this evening where he plays his club ball in front of the American Outlaws and 42,000 plus. The Panamanian anthem.
Seattle recording artist Michael Wassman in singing the Star Spangled Banner.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's whose bright stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight and the ramparts we watched were so gallantly screaming and the rockets reckless, the bombs bursting flag was. Who said
remarkable atmosphere here in Seattle for the United States national team. As Jurgen Klinsmann said, these are home games. He said, these are the must wins. And he's also said the road to the World Cup in Brazil is a bumpy one. And they knew that in the 89th minute on Friday. The United States national team and rebounded on the Evans goal to grab those 3 points. United States 23 consecutive unbeaten matches in qualification at home. You'd have to go back to 2001 for the last time the United States has lost on home soil in a World Cup qualifier. But can the United States play from a position of strength? Panama, if they can crawl out of here with a point, it'd be huge.
Yeah, without a doubt. I think they'll try for a point, and they will take it gladly. But I think it's important for the U.S. to show patience.
Patience, but will we see the high pressure which was unveiled against Germany in Washington last week, which immediately changed the tenor and the German, not the German A team, but let's call it the A minus or B plus team. They had Germany back on their heels with immediate pressure.
Well, you have the perfect weather for it as well. It's nice and cool tonight. You can run all day long. I think the team is really excited for it. And I think that's what you need to do, because you're going to need to create turnovers in good positions, especially with the team that is going to play with 10 guys behind the ball. So if you can win the ball in midfield and take a few guys out of the equation early, you got a chance.
I think you're definitely going to see some HP sauce. High pressure, make them make mistakes in their own end, win the ball in good opportunities in advance, and then make them pay.
The referee is Roberto Garcia of Mexico, as an American, is refereeing this evening. Down in Azteca, you see the U.S. captain, Clint Dempsey, was out there saying, you know, I appreciate what Jurgen Klinsmann does for me, pushing me, making me work harder. Seattle center Eddie Johnson gets the start on the right side of midfield. On the other side of the break, baseball tonight will get underway as this match will switch over to ESPN. The United States and Panama World Cup qualifying to kick in just a moment.
Thank you very much. Welcome to what is an amazing atmosphere for Seattle's first World Cup qualifier for 37 years. More than 40,000 fans in here, and they are generating something quite remarkable. The US with the perfect launch pad, really, to go on and qualify for the World Cup finals in Brazil. And they start a week tomorrow, a day tomorrow, I should say. And these are the standings so far. Costa Rica and Mexico, a goalless draw. So the United States there, remember, the top three automatically qualify, can go top of the group for the first time if they win here tonight. Well, you can feel the excitement of these fans. The USA bringing in Jeff Cameron and Eddie Johnson. A Seattle player, of course, and we've got a full start here amid all of the excitement. Who's your Gatorade performance player tonight then for us, Taylor?
Filling in for Graham Zuzu, who's arguably the best player versus Jamaica. Eddie Johnson will have to be effective, taking players 1-on-1, supporting Josie in the final third, but most importantly, putting in the defensive work in front of his club teammate, Brad Evans, at right back.
Panama unbeaten so far in their four matches, but they've had three of those at home. Remember, the USA have the big advantage now of having four of their last six games on home territory. But there's still an awful lot of work to do. This is Tejada with an early effort on goal. He's Panama's all-time leading scorer, Tejada. USA with Fabian Johnson laying the ball inside towards Altidore, and Dempsey nearly taking that down well in his stride. It was Beloy who got it away in the end. Panama, who drew their most recent game against Mexico, a 0-0 draw. That seems to be the way with the Mexicans in this group. Beasler wide here to Beasley. Try not to get those two confused. Beasler, he's made a thoroughly good impression since coming into the side. In fact, when he and Omar Gonzalez have started together four times, the USA are unbeaten. This match being played on temporary grass here. They've had to rip up the normal artificial surface because it's not deemed suitable, really, for matches at this exalted level. Seattle.
Majority of this game is going to be played just like this. Panama is going to have 10 guys behind the ball. I think the key tonight for the United States is don't get too complacent with just having possession. Can they be effective with that possession in the final third?
I think they'll be looking to play a high tempo here, the USA, and get plenty of crosses in. They feel if Panama do have a weakness, it might be in defending well-delivered crosses, but they will need to be well-delivered. Pass Johnson, Fabian Johnson with the effort. He couldn't quite keep it down, but it was a half-decent chance.
When we saw this a couple times against Germany, that Brad Evans can throw this ball 30, 40 yards. It's all about the second ball on the long throw, and Fabian Johnson does a good job of reading this second touch right here. Unlucky just over the top.
It would have been a great time to get his first goal for the USA, the German-American who plays his football in the Bundesliga for Hoffenheim. Jürgen Klinsmann has called on him to just step up his work a little. Still forms, just tailed off a little bit in one or two recent matches. Here he is on the ball again though now. Fabian Johnson, there's Eddie Johnson on the other side. It's a loose ball by Jeff Cameron, who's come in for Jermaine Jones today. Jones suffered concussion in that win in Jamaica the other night and is not ready for this one. He will be ready for next week, so Cameron comes in midfield, the Stoke City player, very versatile, can play central defence, right back, and tonight an emergency job for him.
Yeah, and I think the relationship with Michael Bradley is key. Anything Panama wants to do off the counters through the middle of the field, so Jeff Cameron, Michael Bradley have to be on the same page, and you heard Alexi Lawless and Casey talk about in the pregame, one of them has to be in front of Gonzalez and Beisler. They both can't get caught going forward.
Cooper trying to find a way through. He's been brought into the side. One of three changes made by Panama, who 2 years ago tonight scored their first ever win on American soil in the Gold Cup, winning by 2-1. An occasion on which Clarence Goodson, who's on the bench tonight for America, scored at both ends. They're hoping lightning might strike twice. The Panamanians, there's great excitement in Panama that they may make the World Cup finals for the very first time in their history. Started well enough, 6 points from four games. It's Amilcar Enriquez playing it forward. Godoy making forward, the tall midfield player, another who's been brought back into the side here tonight. Here he is again. Godoy looking to get the cross away. Taylor, interesting to see how the Panamanians approach the task tonight. A lot of people, including us, thought they might just sit back.
Yeah, and I think the absence of Blas Perez hurts them, but this is a part of the game that has been a struggle for the United States the last three games. Belgium, Germany, Jamaica defending set pieces.
Saw it the other night, didn't we? In Jamaica, it looked like it might be costly until Brad Evans' winner. Panama with the early corner kick here. It's Rodriguez who takes it. Torres won the header. Bouncing around dangerously. They've worked a lot on defending the set pieces better. Now the break's on with Jozy Altidore. Back to form recently. I think the one thing we're learning about this hexagonal, the games are very, very tight indeed. That draw between Mexico and Costa Rica was the seventh so far in the group. Out of 14 matches, half of them, in other words, have been drawn.
And Mexico hasn't scored a goal in over 250 plus minutes at Azteca yet.
And the fans are getting a little restless about that one, of course. USA upbeat mood at the moment. Look at DeMarcus Beasley here, breaking forward from the left back position, getting a decent looking cross, and Eddie Johnson couldn't get there, and then Dempsey rather snatched at his effort. But it's a good move, a pacey move down the flanks, exactly what Jurgen Klinsmann's looking for.
Well, and the talk of the town has been the artificial field having grass on top of it. Every single ball over the top you can get on the end of, and you saw DeMarcus Beasley make sure he gets on the end of that. But this is the key for the United States. It was Friday night against Jamaica, is having more than just Jozy Altidore inside that 18.
Have looked a bit more threatening recently. The goals were a little hard to come by, but now Dempsey's getting support from Altidore again in the scoring stakes. And the supply lines have been better as well. Is Eddie Johnson playing in front of his home fans here, the Seattle Sounder. In fact, it's an all Seattle Sounder right side with Brad Evans behind him. So that's another reason for the fans here to pay their money. Some debate about how high the ticket prices were for this game, but just look at the attendance here tonight. It's another big one, as it always is when the Sounders play here.
Well, and those 3,500 at the Mariners games are missing out.
Offside against Eddie Johnson. They're playing across the road against the Astros. There are the starters tonight. DeMarcus Beasley, 103 caps for him, number 9 all time. And in midfield, the change is Jeff Cameron coming in place of the concussed Jermaine Jones. Josie Altidore up top, but getting plenty of support. Last time the USA played a World Cup qualifier in this city was 37 years ago, 1976, a 2-0 win over Canada when US soccer had 3 employees and now got over 100. And it was unheard of qualifying for the World Cup in that era. Bradley. This is Brad Evans. Jurgen Klinsmann likes him at right back. He might give Steve Cherundolo a run for his money for that position when Cherundolo's properly fit again. Omar Gonzalez. Johnson inside Altidore. Very good first touch from him. Nice technically. Cameron joins in. This is good fluency about this move from the USA so far. DeMarcus Beasley looking to get the right cross in. Might be times tonight when he plays almost like his old role as an out-and-out winger, Beasley, delivering lots of crosses.
But the one way you put a defense that plays with 8 behind the ball on their heels is 2-touch passing, get it out wide, and get your fullbacks overlapping. Beasley in a good spot, good ball in.
Very good pressing by the US there. Cameron losing his footing on this surface, which has had to be kind of stitched together. At quite short notice, Jurgen Klinsmann, after the team had trained last night, ordered that it be cut and rolled again and heavily watered as it was pre-kickoff. Having said that, they had a MLS game here at the weekend in front of 53,000 fans. There were 5 goals and nobody was complaining much except Vancouver Whitecaps. Monica Gonzalez, our touchline reporter, can bring us more of this.
Thanks, Ian. Well, you know the trouble with this patchwork on the temporary fields are the seams. And I had a chance to talk to the grounds crew here. They've been working 8-hour shifts from sunup till sundown using sand to fill in the seams. And they've mowed the grass 8 times since it's been installed last Tuesday. You mentioned Jurgen Klinsmann ordering the grass cut. It's cut at 3/4 inch right now, which is at the lower end of the acceptable range. And I must say, one thing that you can't control with the temporary grass is the roots growing down into the field. In just a few minutes of play, there's already a lot of divots out here. It looks like Taylor's been out here with his pee wedge.
Thanks, Monica. Enjoyed the gardening lesson there.
Did you take notes?
I've written it all down, every single word. But interesting stuff. It is a bit of a problem, and it was given a higher profile by Michael Bradley, giving interviews yesterday, saying it was not ideal, but
it's not. But it's too much of a story for me. And
yeah, they've got to just get on with it.
Got to play on it. Let's go.
I think that was Jurgen Klinsmann's view this morning when we spoke to him. Let's not put any negative thoughts about the surface into the players' heads. There's a job to do. Panama's only away game in the group. So far, they came from behind to get a draw in Jamaica, who do look as if they might start to be detached at the bottom. We'll see. Dempsey goes down and will be a target for opposition players. He's on such a hot streak of scoring, they know he's the player that needs to be stopped. Sometimes it might be foul means as well as fair. Certainly was that time. Bradley to deliver this free kick. It's charged down by Armando Cooper. And Quintero helping out at the back. Here he is on the ball now. Quintero looking to run Brad Evans. He's got a fair bit of speed. That's why he's in, I think, to give them a bit of pace on the break. They'll get a free kick here as well, Panama.
You're talking about Brad Evans' speed, but this is all about Omar Gonzalez covering his right back in a good spot. Little tug from the back from Brad Evans. Fine with that call, but it's a better positioning from Omar Gonzalez to cover up Brad Evans.
And Quintero is still down. One of the greatest players ever for Panama. Now the coach, Julio Dele Valdez. Made a big name for himself in Europe, playing for Cagliari, Paris Saint-Germain, and Malaga.
Amazing, though, a great goal scorer like himself is so focused on defensive shape with Panama. He's completely changed their work as a defensive. Eight guys behind the ball work on their counter. It's amazing that a great goal scorer like himself, and I think that's his twin brother Jorge as well.
Yeah. It's a very good goal return, isn't it, as well? He also scored 203 career goals, probably the best player ever Panama have produced. The feeling is this is their best ever side, though. Played long towards Sanchez, their number eight. A lot of people connected with the Panamanian party thought he might lose his place tonight after an indifferent display against the Mexicans, but he's there again.
Up and down last couple of weeks for Sanchez, being released from DC United as well.
Paris it is, the right fullback with the throw. Tejada trying to hook it back. It went out of play on his journey. Tejada, an interesting character. He had that spell with Real Salt Lake when it didn't go too well on the fitness front, and he was quickly discarded. I don't think the club thought he was ever really in shape, but he certainly does the job when he plays for Panama. His goal return proves it. Nearly a goal every other game. Here's Bradley again, very much the orchestrator in midfield. Give me the ball and I'll try to do something sensible and knit it all together. Beasley's long ball, one for Altidore to chase down the channel, but he's not going to be able to latch on to that one. Honduras still leading Jamaica by a goal to nil with 20 minutes remaining in the other game going on currently in this group. Remember, Mexico and Costa Rica drew 0-0 at the Azteca in the game which finished a few minutes ago. It means Costa Rica have 8 points, Mexico have 8 points, the USA 7, but Mexico currently have played two more games than the USA. Baloy gets it away to Amilcar Enriquez. Wearing gloves, it's not that cold. Quintero is all right again. Tejada had made a run towards the near post. Might have been a problem had the ball been delivered in that area. Got to be fair and say the surface is playing okay. Beautiful sunlit evening here in the stadium right by the Sound in Seattle. pass. Nicely done by the Panamanians, playing their way out of trouble with some neat passing in their own penalty area. Bradley to latch onto it. Midfield might just lack a little bit of the drive Jermaine Jones often gives it, Taylor.
Yeah, but I think right now Jeff Cameron's sitting in front of Gonzalez and Beasler, and Michael Bradley's pushing a little bit higher next to Clint Dempsey.
Cooper. This is football in Argentina. It's been one of the pluses, really, for Panama. Not all their players are confined to the Panamanian league. They're beginning to spread their wings. Fair few play in neighboring Colombia now. Argentina as well. Not too many in Europe, just a couple in this current squad. And neither of them among the starters. It's given us a free kick against Beasler. Cooper is going to take this free kick here for Panama. Taken by Armando Cooper, and Amilcar Enriquez with the header. Here's Jeff Cameron, whose versatility may come to help him when Jürgen Klinsmann eventually sits down, or we hope he does, to pencil the 23 names to take to Brazil.
Agreed, but early on in this game, Jeff Cameron's trying to do a little too much. It's much more in his game to play two-touch, keep it on the ground, and get it out wide to Beasler and Brad Evans going forward.
There's no doubt the two absentees do hurt the USA a little, because Zusi had been in very good form, setting up goals for Altidore in recent matches. He's accumulated a couple of yellow cards, so has to miss a match. He'll be back next week, you presume, anyway.
I think the same could be said for Panama. No Blas Perez and no Gabriel Gomez hurts them as well.
Yeah, Gomez was concussed in the last game. He is on the bench, I noticed, but they've had to watch that. It's probably why he's not in the starting lineup. Usually is. Taylor knows all about those problems, of course.
Well, you have to give credit to U.S. Soccer following the protocol that they've laid out for Jermaine Jones. And to clarify for a lot of those at home, the protocol Jermaine Jones is following is not for tonight's game. It's for the game in Salt Lake for Honduras.
Fair enough. The challenge by Roman Torres. Already on the score sheet in the hex in the first game against Costa Rica. He was coming up from the back. Should have won that game, Panama. Bossing it 2-0 up and allowed Costa Rica back in. Good bit of play that by Eddie Johnson. His every touch being cheered by his hometown fans here. Fabian Johnson inside. Cameron with a cute little flick towards Dempsey. Wasn't a bad idea.
It's been a very good start with Fabian Johnson and DeMarcus Beasley on this left-hand side.
Dempsey's the player getting penalized here.
But this is the second or third time that when Clint Dempsey has run those channels out wide, Beloy's followed him. That's what you want for the United States, because if Dempsey can pull Beloy out wide, then Josie Altidore's one-on-one in the middle with Torres.
The voice of Taylor Twellman, who has a World Cup goal in a qualifier against Panama to his name. I think it was your first one for the USA, wasn't it?
Yeah, it only took me about 175 games to get one, but I got one.
You're being too hard on yourself. It was the last time the two countries have played a World Cup qualifier against each other. Now then, look at this from Michael Bradley. Good run from midfield. Fabian Johnson here. Not really away. Bradley's got a chance. Oh, that might have been on his way in, but it hit Dempsey on the way. That's unfortunate. I just wonder whether that would have nestled in the corner without hitting Dempsey.
Well, I don't think there's any doubt about it, but what can Clint Dempsey really do? But what I like about that play is Michael Bradley pushing forward. You talk about the absence of Jermaine Jones, Jeff Cameron playing that number six role. But this is where Michael Bradley can surprise you with long runs coming out of the midfield. But watch this, he stays with the play. He's looking for that second ball. It's just unlucky. What can Dempsey do?
It's a dreadful defensive header by Rodriguez to set up that chance. But now here he is overlapping and losing his footing at the other end. Now, I wonder whether that is a bit of a problem with the pitch there. Because what other explanation?
And we've heard everyone talk about Monica Gonzalez's report. That's not the field. That's Carlos Rodriguez tripping over his own foot. I'm mistaken. He is slipping there.
There was something amiss, wasn't there? Otherwise, keep your eye on the fresh air. Beasley, Sporting Kansas City man, made good. Becoming a regular for the U.S. national side. Back on the ball again. He's already faced Chicharito, Hernandez, Miroslav Klose, Christian Benteke of Belgium. In at the deep end, you could say, is Cooper. Look, a bit of a threat down that left-hand side when they're attacking Panama, doing some quite good work, and the bounce nearly going their way before Omar Gonzalez nicked that away from the overlapping Rodriguez.
That's great work from Jeff Cameron. And I think there were questions about Panama going forward without Blas Perez. What they've done with Quintero, Cooper, Sanchez running off Tejada, they've been a little bit more quick in that final third and a little bit more dynamic early on.
Don't forget the 2013 Confederations Cup begins this Saturday on ESPN. Brazil kicking off the tournament against Japan. The hosts, of course, will have every game starting with Brazil against Japan Saturday, 2:30 on ESPN, and also live on the Watch ESPN app. About halfway through the first half here. Goalless so far. USA bright in patches. Altidor fizzed the ball into Dempsey, just got caught under his feet. He's on one of the hottest scoring streaks in US history, is Clint Dempsey at the moment. 7 in 7. It's not quite number one on the list, but it's up there. Quintero looks a problem, gets around Brad Evans, and Tejada attacking that near post. Quintero does look a threat. He's making it pretty hard work. It's a big examination, I think, for Brad Evans there.
Quintero sets up Brad Evans perfectly with a little fake. But this is great defensive work from Matt Beisler. Tejada makes a good run near post, and Beisler there answers the call. Brad Evans has to be more on his toes on that one-on-one defender.
Remember the USA with this astonishingly good home record in World Cup qualifying, unbeaten for the last 12 years and 23 matches, of which 21 have been victories. Honduras, it was the last team to win away in the USA in a World Cup qualifier back in Washington, D.C. in 2001. Sanchez, Tejada ahead of him, wanted too much time. It's good covering by DeMarcus Beasley. He does have that recovery speed, helps him a lot. Bradley looking to get Eddie Johnson in behind here. Beloyo just let that run through to the goalkeeper, Jaime Pinedo, who's winning his 84th cap. Rodriguez. Doesn't look as if that Deli Valdez, the Panamanian coach, has had a look at the USA and thinks the way to maybe attack them is down that side.
Well, we saw Friday night at home against Mexico, they had all 11 players in their own half of the field. Their line of confrontation tonight is much higher than expected. the space for Cameron and Bradley to play out of the back is much more limited than they thought coming in. But Ian, you and I were talking about at breakfast, and I said the biggest thing they have to be careful on the United States is getting complacent with possession. And right now, they're consistently just knocking the ball around the back. Why not get Fabian Johnson, Eddie Johnson, Josie Altidore over the top?
Altidore looking for a 1-2 here with Dempsey. Now it's Eddie Johnson. Chip towards Altidore, well defended by Roman Torres. Going the aerial route, the USA hoping one of these crosses will hit the jackpot. Definitely a situation where patience is a virtue. Cameron. Gonzalez, the LA Galaxy man, has made that central defensive position his own. Possession rather squandered in the end. The nearest thing, really, that shot by Michael Bradley, which hit Clint Dempsey on the way through. Outlaws here in numbers and making a good noise. Seattle will be hoping it's not another 37 years before they get another qualifier. Altidore let it run. Is Dempsey. Now Fabian Johnson. Support arriving in the middle. The cross needed to be better than that. It was easy for Beloy. A bit disappointing from Fabian Johnson, has been moved forward from the left-back position in the last few matches. Alberto Quintero again. Again running Evans, who needs to be careful. Was there any nudge there? Quintero thought there was. Need to be careful. He was looking for the penalty. The referee very, very close there, the Mexican Roberto Garcia.
Well, Brad Evans is having a conversation with Eddie Johnson right now because Brad Evans cannot get called one-on-one here with Quintero. Good no call from the referee. But at some point, either Omar Gonzalez, Eddie Johnson, Jeff Cameron has to slide over because Brad Evans is having a difficult time defending one-on-one.
The contact looked minimal, but Quintero felt he had a case there. Certainly was inside the box. Eddie Johnson plays a nice little 1-2 down that side. It's away by Torres. Two big, muscular central defenders to get past for the U.S. Did Altidore hand over? Nope. Referee's happy enough. Amilcar Enriquez. The other Enriquez, Luis, who scored a couple of times in the hex already, left out of the side rather surprisingly tonight. He's gone for the extra pace of Quintero on that left-hand side. It's a nice touch there by Sanchez. Not wanted by DC United. Didn't happen for him there. Back in the United States, wondering where his future may be. Certainly got a future by the look of it in the Panama side. Inside to Godoy, who's looking for a little chip ball. There was nobody making a run there. One or two accusing glances from his teammates at that. Going to be a free kick here. Don't forget, on Saturday following the opener of the Confederations Cup, it's two of the top teams in MLS's Western Conference meeting. FC Dallas goes into Portland to take on the Timbers. 5 o'clock Eastern on ESPN for that one. It's also live on the Watch ESPN app.
So this is your first time in the Pacific Northwest, huh?
Yeah, enjoyed it as well.
Where were you all week?
Well,
Vancouver?
I went to Vancouver, and now I'm Seattle, and they're both wonderful places. Soccer crazy city here, isn't it? Seattle. Now the USA with a corner kick.
Well, and this is the area of the game, attacking set pieces, that I think the United States can really punish Panama without Blas Perez, without Gomez. They now have a size advantage with Gonzalez, Beasler, Evans, Dempsey, Eddie Johnson, Jeff Cameron. Take advantage of it.
Lots of white shirts in there. He's not happy about something down in that corner. Now he is. Quite clear what he was looking at there. The referee. Bradley takes it now. Pinedo got something on it, not that much. Back in again by Fabian Johnson. Dempsey, good header down. Bradley, that's not good. Dempsey back in again. It's penalty area ping pong, and in the end, it's cleared.
Great work from Fabian Johnson. Both Bradley, Cameron, Clint Dempsey were pushed forward. Well done to stop the counter.
Johnson showing a good turn of pace there. And the cross too long, by a long way. Eddie Johnson, who once scored a hat-trick against Panama, coming on as a substitute in about 25 minutes. They'll know about him. Was back in 2004, mind you. Done by Altidore, that very deft piece of control. DeMarcus Beasley. Oh, well played by Altidore. Now, was he brought down there? What does the referee give? He gives a free kick to Panama in the end. Altidore is furious. He thinks he should have had a spot kick there.
Well, and you wonder what two goals does for a confidence in a striker that scored 31 goals in Europe. It's this right here. That is exactly what Jurgen Klinsmann wants from Jozy Altidore. Big, strong, holds off Torres. That's a penalty kick.
Yeah, it looks like it to me.
That's
too.
A penalty 100%. Torres comes in late.
Yep, that's a penalty.
Jozy Altidore has him beat. That's a penalty.
Definitely caught his leg, not the ball. The referee was close enough and said no.
But how promising was that big, strong turn from that man right there?
It's amazing, as you said, what a couple of goals will do.
Oh, the weight of the world's off your shoulders here.
Yeah. He's cut off doing interviews during this camp because he wants to concentrate and focus on getting his form back. Well, that form has returned. He's looking a threat again here. Look at this run from Bradley. Real drive from the Roma man. Now then, Fabian Johnson, can he get this right? Cross the face of goal, and yes, it's Altidore again for the third game running, and the US have the lead after a picture book move. Cue delirium in Seattle.
The United States is at their best when this ball gets out wide. Because you look at Jozy Altidore, you see Clint Dempsey, Michael Bradley, but watch this run from Clint Dempsey. He gets near post. That brings the defender here back post, wide open for Jozy Altidore. But what's been the key for Jozy Altidore? He's been up front by himself for the first 18 months under Jurgen Klinsmann. Jamaica Friday night, Clint Dempsey made that run. Tonight he does. Jozy Altidore with his third goal in three games.
First time he's ever done that in a USA shirt. But what a fabulous ball from Fabian Johnson that was as well. Exactly the right pace to dissect the defense.
It's the whole run of play. Michael Bradley with the penetrating run, finding Fabian Johnson. But it is so important for your center striker to have support with runs inside that 18. Clint Dempsey with an unselfish run near post. Opens up Jozy back post.
Great goal for the USA. Well, Panama strike back. Sanchez did quite well to keep that in play. Harris with the cross in. They have to keep their defensive organization. Panama looking to bite straight back again here. It's good awareness by Omar Gonzalez. It puts a lot of red shirts forward, but now the brakes on. Bradley. Oh, his play towards Dempsey instead. Altidore wanted it played in his path. He thought he was in behind for a moment there.
So important that you get that first goal in the first half, though, Ian, because now it opens up the game. Now human nature sets in for Panama. They're going to chase the game. You've got them on the ropes here.
Good bit of play. Eddie Johnson looks to get the right cross. Torres gets it away. And then Cameron with a header from must have been nearly 25 yards. He did score against Belgium, his first goal for his country recently. Beasler is caught underneath that one for a moment. I have to say the Panamanians do look as if they carry a bit of threat themselves as well here. It's no formality, this is it, even with the one goal lead.
No, especially with Sanchez, Quintero and Cooper running off underneath Tejada. They're a little bit quicker, a little bit more dynamic. So the United States has to be extremely careful on the counterattack. And that's the relationship of Jeff Cameron and Michael Bradley. One of them stay in front of Beasler and Gonzalez and help them deal with Tejada.
The USA have now scored in 29 of their last 30 World Cup qualifiers. The exception was a very good goalless draw away in the Azteca. Mind you, Jamaica have got one as well, and tonight Costa Rica too. It's becoming a habit. One thing the USA do have to watch as well tonight, six of the starters have already got one yellow card in the competition. Another one would mean they'd be suspended next week against Honduras in Salt Lake City. Good responses. Cooper, be careful with the challenge there. Cameron, and it worked for him.
I mean, Jeff Cameron just looks much more natural playing centrally with Michael Bradley. It's not the same player that was playing right back and struggling against Belgium.
But he still thinks central defense is his best position. He can't get in the Stoke side playing there. They've been using him mainly at right back.
But come World Cup time, you need those two or three joker players that are so versatile. Jeff Cameron's one of them.
Yeah. He'd probably be on the list of bankers for that World Cup 23 at this stage, but a lot can change in a year. Fabian Johnson in, just rolled on. It's another good idea, though. The USA certainly look to be carrying much more attacking threat in one or two of the recent games than has been apparent in one or two others. It's only the second home game in the hex, this for the US. The other one was the snowy win against Costa Rica. Jürgen Klinsmann says the snow hurt us more than Costa Rica. We'd have won it 3 or 4-0 because we were playing that well until the blizzard came. Costa Rica might have a slightly different view of it. In fact, they have. They protested to FIFA to no avail. It is amazing, though, the change in Jose Altidore in the last, well, week and a half, really, since the Belgium game when he was substituted at half-time. He just looked completely out of sorts with himself.
Yeah, but Ian, you don't score 31 goals in Europe by accident.
Yeah, exactly.
And it's all about service, and a lot of people have talked about Graham Zuzzi providing that service, but look, Fabian Johnson has started 3 games, not including tonight, for the U.S. national team at left midfielder, left wing. They've scored 9 goals.
DeMarcus Beasley, Altidore looked for the layoff. Bradley looked to control that. You could see him try to get his body weight over that to keep it down. He couldn't quite manage it, even a scorer of spectacular goals usually, Bradley.
A huge positive for the United States in this first half. It's not one, it's not two, it's not three players inside that 18. Look at that right there. That's 5 U.S. players putting pressure on that back four from Panama.
USA, one up. Good penalty shout as well. Although Panama will say they might have had one themselves for Evans' little tug. on Quintero. Good game. Temper's just beginning to boil a little. There's so much at stake, of course. This very final round of World Cup qualifying. It'll be the halfway point in the hex for the USA after this. Remember, if they win this game, they go top of the group for the first time. And would be in a very, very handsome position. Usually it takes 16 points to make absolutely certain of going through. If they win this, they'd be up to 10 with half the program still to come. Bradley, lovely ball, beautifully measured for Fabian Johnson. Here's Dempsey. Look full of ideas, and just once or twice that Panamanian defense does look at sixes and sevens. Struggling to cope with the movement of the U.S. players a little bit, Taylor, aren't they?
Especially when Fabian Johnson tucks inside next to Clint Dempsey and DeMarcus Beasley overlaps. Harris, Sanchez, Torres, they're really having a difficult time when Beasley makes that overlapping run, and then Fabian Johnson opens up the channels to combine with either Michael Bradley or Clint Dempsey.
Nicely done by Armando Cooper. There's his football in Argentina. Pacey, incisive sort of player, getting in the right positions. Tejada. He's got to make sure he doesn't get on the end of anything when it's not presented with a chance, because he is likely to take it. Nicely done. Appreciative applause from this big, big crowd at CenturyLink Field in Seattle. They did put a ceiling on the attendance of around 42,000 tonight because of the Mariners game going on next door.
Against the Astros. And I know you don't know that, but those may be the two worst teams in Major League Baseball. So the 3,500 at that game right now are missing a show here.
I'll leave you to answer the letters. Here's Quintero cutting inside. He does look a bit of a threat, but his shot's a poor one from him. He has looked Panama's most dangerous weapon so far. A player who started playing amateur football in Spain, was plucked from obscurity and up into fully fledged league football. Now playing for Chirilo in Panama. What you've seen here, I think, is the USA's level of confidence on the back of the excellent 3 points in Jamaica. It's going to be a minute of stoppage time at the end of this half.
Well, and Ian, how important was that goal from Brad Evans? Imagine they don't come back and get the 3 points there. This is a completely different mindset coming into tonight's game.
Marcos Sanchez played in. Here's Tejada, offside. Ball's in the back of the net. It's not going to count. The flag was up a long time before he poked it over the line, to the point where Howard didn't even try to stop it. But again, they looked quite inventive here, Panama.
Well, and we've seen a couple times when Sanchez comes in, Tejada's offside perfectly, but Godoy's pushed forward, and that's made it life difficult for Beasley and Gonzalez. They did a good job there on the same page, stepping forward.
The player they call El Matador, Tejada, foiled that time. Decision was correct, though, as you saw on the replay. A Jozy Altidore goal again, doing the trick for the United States, who lead deservedly by a goal to nil. Altidore scoring for the first time, three games running for the USA. It was a beautiful move as well, with Bradley and Fabian Johnson playing a full part in it. Plenty of drama still to come, though, here. USA 1, Panama 0 at halftime, as we hand it back to Bob.
Thank you, Ian. And Taylor, the awakened brilliance that is Jozy Altidore, 31 goals in the Netherlands in league and cup playing. And three straight matches now he scored for the United States here at the break, looking for three more points here in Seattle. And it really was a work of precision and possession.
And patience. And when you look at this goal, it's about simplicity. Not anything crazy going on here. Very, very efficient. All right, the U.S. wins the ball. Jeff Cameron's going to play a nice, simple ball out. Now watch Michael Bradley. Take space. Make the defenders make decisions. Play it out wide. All half long. Ivan Johnson was cutting it back to his right foot. Not this time. He played the way he faced. A beautiful ball in. Wonderful play from the entire team. And then obviously to get the goal from Josie.
Fantastic team effort to get the goal. But now it's a case of just, you see, in that last 5-6 minutes, Panama starting to get in the game a little bit. A little bit offside from Tejeda on the goal, but a little bit Quintero on the outside, giving Brad Evans a little bit of trouble. So now they got to just settle down a little bit, continue to put that high pressure on. Don't back off and let Panama dictate play.
They have shown certainly that Panama, a talented side. Jurgen Klinsmann worried about his team switching it off at times. It didn't happen here. 16th goal. Jose Altidore in the national team shirt. Passes Kobe Jones for 9th all-time. Highlights of Mexico in here as we come back. First time since the bicentennial year of 1976, the city of Seattle hosting a World Cup qualifier, and they are having a party at the half. Jose Altidore lighting it with the goal in the 36th minute. Okay, Mexico-Costa Rica. Scoreless draws the way it ended, but Joel Campbell made it very interesting in the first half for Costa Rica.
Yeah, this is not what Mexico wanted to see right off the post early on. Oh, my goodness. Look at this.
This is at Azteca, where Mexico still have yet to score in this round of qualifying. Thank goodness for Joe Corona if you're an L3 fan.
Well, right before halftime, another big save from Corona. I mean, Corona has really been the star of the hexagonal for Mexico.
Salcido's attempt. This in the second half. And then an incident in about the 70th minute. Brian Ruiz constantly hit over the course of 4 or 5 minutes by objects from the crowd.
Well, it's happened to me so many times at different venues in CONCACAF, and I like to see what the American officials did as they really slowed things down and got the safety of the player first.
Yeah, waste of a good beverage there. Look, there weren't a lot of highlights for Mexico. Chicharito just absolutely desperate and frustrated trying to figure out a way to score a goal. Doesn't happen.
All right, Mexico played 6 matches. They've got 8 points. You start to wonder if Chepo de la Torre, their head coach, is a dead man walking.
Oh, boy. Oh,
you'll wonder about that, don't you? It's a lot of pressure, and the calls will start immediately in the Mexican media. Costa Rica will gladly take the point. In the United States, it's clear the way is open. A win tonight would put them on top of the Hex 16 tournament and leading with 10 points. It'd be a great place to be for the United States. You guaranteed on that, or someone who looked a lot like you on national television, guaranteed the U.S. are going to Brazil yesterday.
Yeah, when they win tonight.
All right.
And they'll end the half. Yeah. I mean, we talked about it before. And they've played this first half the way they needed to play it, with patience. They waited for their moments. They went down the right side. They went down the left side. They got crosses in. They created opportunities. They got the goal they needed. Now they got to be smart.
Yeah. Panama has the skill, and they've shown that.
Panama's shown a little bit on the counterattack. They got a little rhythm late in the half. U.S. needs to make sure they just continue to step guys forward, put them under pressure, and if they do that, I think they'll cruise it.
So right now, the United States sitting on that lead, enjoying the ambiance of this evening in the Pacific Northwest. Altidore's goal. Bradley and Bobby and Johnson setting it up. He's in form. It's been a physical match as well. We'll be back. They weren't allowed to sell every ticket here at Seattle because of the baseball game next year. It's about an average crowd for the Seattle Sounders in the low 40s. A 1-0 U.S. lead over Panama. It came in the 36th minute, and his name is Jose Altidore.
Now, we talked to Jurgen Klinsmann this morning, and he told us that he had talked to Fabian Johnson saying, you need to make more of an impact. You need to be involved. Well, this is a wonderful play from start to finish. Jeff Cameron, a nice simple ball up to Michael Bradley, who takes space, makes defenders make decisions, and then a nice ball outside of Bobby Johnson, who we talked about all half was cutting it back to his preferred right foot, but on this one, he sees it, he plays it,
and that's a beautiful thing right there for Jose Altidore.
Yeah, it starts with Michael Bradley committing defenders. You come out of midfield, you make guys make choices, you have options on both sides, it freezes defenders, Clint makes the perfect run, Josie makes the perfect run, numbers in the box, perfect cross, you score goals.
forgotten now was what had been a 24-month run of play scoring drought for Jozy Altidore with the national team. He's not talking about that, not granting interviews, concentrating on the football, and it has resulted in goals in three consecutive matches now and a halftime lead in this qualifier in Seattle, United States, looking for 3 points, which would take them top of the qualifying group if they can win this tonight.
Welcome back to CenturyLink Field in Seattle. United States 1, Panama 0 at halftime in this vital World Cup qualifier. What's the verdict so far? Let's join the USA coach, Jürgen Klinsmann, who's with Monica Gonzalez.
Coach, after you guys scored the goal, I saw you hollering at the defense to keep the ball moving. How important is it for you guys to keep a high tempo in the second half?
Oh, it's very important. We got to keep the tempo going. We got to keep the energy going. And we got to score a second goal. Obviously, we got to control our defensive shape, you know, not giving up anything, but we need the second goal to close it down.
I saw that the transition from defense to offense seemed to be really quick and really decisive. Are you happy with the chances that you guys created in the first half?
Yeah, I know we are very happy with the way things are going, you know, how they play out of the back, how they find, you know, Clint and Josie up front, how these the outsides get involved with Eddie and Fabian. So overall, very, very positive, but obviously we need another goal to get the 3 points and finish it off.
Thanks for your time, Coach. Appreciate it. Ian, back to you.
Thanks very much indeed. These fans are enjoying this so far. Only the second World Cup qualifier ever played in this soccer crazy city. No substitutions made so far by either team. It's interesting, Taylor, to hear Jürgen Klinsmann saying that they feel they need the insurance of a second goal. I'd agree with that.
Well, and I think mainly because there's been concern of giving up that late goal. They gave one up Friday night in Jamaica defensively. Second goal really puts this game away.
DeMarcus Beasley now in the top 10 all time with 103 caps. He's gone ahead of our very own Casey Keller tonight on that list. Still headed, of course, by Kobe Jones in 164. Beautiful piece of work that by Cameron. Turned his man very cleverly indeed. Win for Honduras tonight to put them back in the hunt a bit. They're up to 7 points, which is what the United States started the night with. Mexico and Costa Rica, after their draw, have 8. Klinsmann wanted a Mexico win tonight. He feels they will qualify. They just want to put a gap between themselves and the other hopefuls in the group.
Well, and I think U.S. soccer fans wanted one team to really drop an egg, and that's been Jamaica. You know, when you have one team really give up points to other teams, I think that definitely helps the United States push forward, especially if they get 3 points tonight.
Cooper. Amilcar Enriquez helping this forward to Sanchez. Interesting to see what measures the USA might take to deal with the dangerous Quintero. Eddie Johnson might need to give a little bit of help there to Brad Evans behind him. Two Seattle players, of course. Dempsey is only growing into the captaincy, it seems to me, with every press conference. He seems more comfortable in the role, and he's certainly leading from the front out on the pitch. Tim Howard, largely unemployed so far. He'll be quite happy to keep it that way as well. 89th cap for him tonight. He's on course to become the number one goalkeeper appearance-wise of all time. It's another Casey one on 102. Clint Dempsey, by the way, is winning cap number 98 tonight, so he'll be the next into the Century Club. Beasley looks as if he's been playing in that defense for far longer than he has. It's only his 6th cap tonight. Hard to believe that, Taylor.
Well, and I think a lot of people have talked about, you know, Omar Gonzalez coming into that role. I'd argue that Matt Beasler has been the better of the two at center back the last three or four games.
It's only been a bonus find. Cameron, good driving run through the midfield. Dempsey here. Very good challenge in the end by Baloy, captain and leader for Panama at the back.
And that is the meat and potatoes of Baloy defensively. So strong, one-on-one, doesn't bite on that fake from Clint Dempsey.
You've played against him, haven't you?
Yeah, the one thing about Baloy is he's very involved in the physical battles of the game, but what he loses track of is when that ball goes out wide, he has the split second, he gets caught ball watching, and I think Josie out the door in the first half, Clint Dempsey coming in underneath. You want to get Baloy thinking about those runs inside the 18.
Here is Felipe Baloy right on cue. Look at this run. All came to nothing in the end. Godoy is saying to him, I could have done with that on the floor, really. Is a very small country, so they're doing well to make an argument of it in this hex. Only 3.5 million people. Los Canaleros, the canal men. Is Armando Cooper. Possession football here from Panama. They don't look in any particular hurry. They'll be fully aware that if they conceded a second, it might be curtains. And that ball is just given away by Amilcar Enriquez. He sets up Dempsey for this run. He wanted a free kick. He's not getting one. Panama give it away again. One or two inquests going on among their players. Again, looks like he's enjoying that midfield job tonight. It all adds to the options that Jurgen Klinsmann is developing around the team, which is very helpful because you're always going to have to cover for suspensions and injuries. Every team has to.
Well, and it also raises the stock of Jeff Cameron because not only can he play anywhere on the back line, he can play in the middle. The storyline coming into this game is whose depth was going to be better, whose bench was going to be better. No Graham Zuzi, no Jermaine Jones. But Jeff Cameron's been the man of the match for me. He's been very strong in that relationship with Michael Bradley in that first half have been key. Now this second half, though, Josie Altidore, Eddie Johnson, Fabian Johnson, they need to keep the killer instinct going and go for that second goal.
Rather than sit on the one goal, which is always the temptation. You heard Jurgen Klinsmann with Monica Gonzalez at halftime making that point, and I'm sure he's made it to the players. We need a second. We want to be holding on in the last few minutes. Panama are bound to throw more men forward late on, you'd think anyway. Here's Brad Evans. What a week he's had. He couldn't have scripted it any better. He'd done the whole thing himself. First of all, marking Lucas Podolski out of the game against Germany and then scoring the winner in Jamaica. Cameron's ball is a beauty. Eddie Johnson does it on his home turf. 2-0 the USA. That's the one they wanted. Now there's clear water. And what a peach of a pass by Jeff Cameron to set that up.
And Jeff Cameron finds the space in the midfield and picks it up, but this is a perfect run from Eddie Johnson because his first two steps are to the centrally. He doesn't go forward. He looks right across that line, makes sure he's onside. What a ball from Jeff Cameron. Perfect first touch. And that's an easy finish for a player like Eddie Johnson. That is a great ball, but I love the run from Eddie Johnson because too often that winger, that forward is offside. He times it perfectly. Great first touch. U.S. is up 2-0.
How he loved that. In front of his home fans, the Seattle Sounder scoring in Seattle. And by the way, it's his 11th World Cup qualifying goal in history. Only Landon Donovan and Clint Dempsey ahead of him on that list. Another very, very well taken goal. Tejada was looking for the 1-2 around the edge of the box. But the USA at the moment are just outclassing Panama, really. Long road this as well for the Panamanians. They have to start earlier in the competition on the cycle than the USA. If they do make it to the World Cup finals, they'll have earned it, because they'll have to play 20 qualifiers in all. Got it to do here, though. Here's Quintero. Brad Evans needs to get back. Here's Cooper looking to get Panama back into the argument. Quintero going down in the box rather easily. Quite a comeback from the USA in this group as we look at Eddie Johnson's statistics and his excellent record I was telling you about in World Cup qualifiers. Remember the USA, there was a lot of consternation when they were beaten away from home by Honduras in the first game of the Hex, and everybody's thinking, oh goodness me, this could turn ugly. But they're taking 7 points out of 9 going into this one, and they're 2 up here. Bradley and Cameron dominating that midfield argument tonight. USA determined to make sure there's another World Cup finals waiting around the corner for them. And here comes a booking for Altidore. He's not one of the players who's already got one yellow, so he will be okay for the game next week against Honduras. Dempsey's one of those who has got a yellow already, and so too Michael Bradley. Didn't want to be without either of those two. Tejada lays it off to Roman Torres. What are those red-shirted Panamanians pressing forward as they have to? They have to chase this a little now. But they might be a little worried too about goal difference. Made by Beasler. Those defenders will be desperate to keep a clean sheet, do nothing silly after the rather soft goal they conceded late on in Jamaica the other night. Free kick, simple as that. The chances, we are going to Brazil from the American Outlaws. In party mood, all right. Dempsey, Altidore. Look at the white shirt streaming forward here. DeMarcus Beasley. Beasley, by the way, is heading towards his fourth World Cup. He was just a 20-year-old in 2002. He was in that famous win over Portugal. Long, long way back he goes.
run. It's a great run forward from DeMarcus Beasley, but Fabian Johnson kills him by tucking inside.
Play on, says the referee. Torres got himself in a bit of a mix, and then he gives a free kick against the USA. Here's something. So far in this group, and I think we've had something like 14 matches before this one kicked off, nobody'd scored three goals in a game yet, that tight. Can the USA do that?
I think exactly the way what they've been doing, and that is get the ball out wide, because Panama has struggled when that ball gets out wide. And they're looking to make two subs here as well.
Great second goal from the U.S. tonight, Taylor.
Well, and this is all about Eddie Johnson, because terrible positioning from Carlos Rodriguez. So instead of making the run here, he makes this run curling to stay onside, and a great ball from Jeff Cameron. Textbook on how to make a run and use that to defender to your advantage from Eddie Johnson.
Wonderful goal. And while you were looking at that, Panama made a substitution, in fact, two. They're bringing on Rolando Blackburn, taking off Godoy in midfield, and Banahana is coming on to replace Armando Cooper. So two changes made by Julio Dele Valdez, the Panamanian coach, to do something, really. It's Banahana looking to play the ball forward there. Rodriguez takes the throw. Played in by Barahona. There's work to do for Howard. He punched it downwards. Cameron was in the right place again. He's having a fine match in there. Quintero's gone out to the right wing, meanwhile. They give DeMarcus Beasley a problem or two. It's a nice ball in, and that was Blackburn with the header. Virtually his first touch of the ball. In fact, I think he was.
It was his first touch, and you've seen exactly what Barahona can come into this game, and then you have Blackburn playing next to Tejada as that second striker. Tejada is much more comfortable with someone next to him up front. Blackburn's come in and been dangerous early on.
Blackburn's one of those two players in this squad who plays his...
Abel Aguilar also, who knows what's going to happen now that Deportivo got relegated. Here's Cuadrado.
Aguilar has been heavily linked to Granada recently, so he could be playing in La Liga as well, even though Deportivo won that.
Gutierrez. Aguilar fighting through the challenge. He got stopped.
You leave me out playing this well. Gonzalez had to wait a long time for it. You leave me out playing this well. Gonzalez had to wait a long time for his chance to be part of the U.S. senior team. There was a lot of debate. Should he be used? Should he not be used? And he's come in and looked pretty solid in the main. Playing this well. Gonzalez had to wait a long time for his chance to be part of the U.S. senior team. There was a lot of debate. Should he be used? Should he not be used? And he's come in and looked pretty solid in the main. Maybe the odd error, but that's to be expected.
When you wonder about Omar Gonzalez, it being his contract year, if that's weighing on him now coming up in the June and July transfer window, how much is that in the back of his mind?
I think he might be the kind of centre-back who would appeal to some of the European clubs. Relatively short supply, top-class defenders.
Well, I think it puts the ball in LA Galaxy's court, because if they don't sign Gio Dos Santos or go out and get that big European third DP, why not make Omar Gonzalez that guy?
It's a good thought, that, isn't it? I think you might have started a debate there, Taylor.
But look at how bad LA Galaxy are without Omar Gonzalez.
Barahona here does some good work on that left-hand side. It's not really got away yet either. Back in Rodriguez.
See, this is a difficult test now for Beasley and Gonzalez because now they're dealing with two center forwards. Played 62, 63 minutes of dealing with just Tejada up front. Now Blackburn's come in. Communication's key in the first 10 minutes of this, dealing with Tejada and Blackburn up front.
Just in that situation where one goal for Panama would change the mood and dynamic of this game completely. The U.S. will be fully aware of that, as will Jurgen Klinsmann. It's been a habit of allowing the odd silly goal.
I think shutout tonight is huge for the United States and their defensive confidence.
Certainly pushing a lot of men forward, though. Panama now, as they have to roll the dice a bit, don't they? Barahona, good little ball. He's made a good start since coming on the left-hand side. Plays his football in Colombia. Has a goal against Argentina to his name as well. Sanchez. It's a loose ball. They can't afford to be doing that, Panama. The US might just fancy the way this game is set up now. They can possibly look to pick Panama off on the counter. Good fluency. Dempsey linking up the play very well there with Altidore. Those two looking to work together. It was a little bit loose from Altidore, the return pass. Quintero doing well there. Tejada with the layoff. Panama suggesting that they might be able to claw their way back into the argument. Gonzalez had some work to do there under pressure. Amilcar Enriquez dispossessed. Now the break is on. Cameron can lead it. Altidore to one side. Dempsey's up there as well. Here is Clint Dempsey. Beautifully done. Altidore. They need one more in there. Altidore goes alone. Great effort. Dempsey! Oh, he's hit the bar. He's hit the bar. Could have been. Could have been.
Great combination play, but this play all started from Jeff Cameron. Great work to pick up his head. But we've seen more combination play from Josie Altidore and Clint Dempsey than we've seen the last four or five games combined. And it all comes from playing two-touch and an understanding that you can play into Clint Dempsey. He'll lay it off, then knock him in behind. Good work from Altidore and Clint.
Seems to be developing a bit of a chemistry up there, which is what you want, of course. Fabian Johnson forward. Altidore was looking to let that run. Sold a dummy, but Beloy wasn't buying it. I think Panama's away form, most of their games remaining are away, will determine whether they do make history and make it to the World Cup finals. Barahona from a long way out. Howard can just watch that, really. Always had it covered. This year's Confederations Cup begins this Saturday on ESPN. Two-time defending Confed Cup champions Brazil kicking off the tournament against Japan, who've already qualified for the World Cup. We'll have every game starting with that game Saturday, 2:30 on ESPN and also live on the Watch ESPN app.
You know, Ian, you look at the time, you look at the score, 68 minutes into this game. Now you have to start thinking about Tuesday in Salt Lake. Clint Dempsey's on a yellow card. Michael Bradley's on a yellow card. Fabian Johnson, Josie Altidore. At what point does Jurgen Klinsmann maybe look at his bench to come in and finish this game out?
It's an interesting thought. Maybe the answer's not quite yet. He may feel there's still work to do. We'll just show you there. There are all the players who are currently on one yellow card. Brad Davis is not out there at the moment, of course. But they get another one, they're going to miss the game against Honduras. It's a tough disciplinary code, all right, with all the games in
it's ridiculous. Hard two yellow cards and you're suspended? Mm. And there's no time limit on it.
You can write the email to them.
I'm signing your name.
Sanchez did well, goes down, and the referee is going to book him here for diving. That's what he's going to do. Yellow card for diving there for Marcos Sanchez. His American nightmare goes on. He was given the elbow, really, by DC United, and now the embarrassment of a yellow card for what is euphemistically called simulation.
And that's great recognition from the referee, who's had a decent game other than the missed penalty in the first half on Jozy Altidore. Too often you see referees reluctant to make that call. Well done.
This referee, by the way, is on the preliminary list of 52 for the World Cup finals. Cameron's got a yellow card here as well. These yellow cards are beginning to build up a bit. Everybody's on thin ice, it would seem. Rodriguez here for Panama. Play again on Tuesday as well, the Panamanians. Traveling to Costa Rica, another very difficult away game where they would not be fancied, really, especially in strength-sapping game on this surface here as well, which might leave it in their legs a little. It's given away, rather, by Fabian Johnson. Rodriguez to play it in. Bit of space on this side for Quintero. If he gets it right, Tejada. Very important challenge from Beisler. And an offside flag anyway. Coming to a stadium not so near you in Brazil next year.
Is the hair on the back of your neck standing up right now?
Well, it is superb support, yeah. I think the players will appreciate it, and there's not much doubt that the United States team will want to come back to Seattle sooner rather than later. And why not?
You can play in a sand pit for all I care if you're in front of this crowd.
Makes a difference, doesn't it?
Oh, it's unbelievable.
Gonzalez doing well in his Eddie Johnson score of that second goal, a vital second goal, which has just given the USA a bit of breathing space. Had a lot of enterprising football going forward, encouragingly, tonight. Dempsey continues his dialogue with the referee. It's been going on for most of the night. Not all along the lines of an invitation to his next party. Eddie Johnson, his first touch. Bradley picks a nice ball. Dempsey looking for the 1-2 with Fabian Johnson. There's a bit of invention about the U.S.'s attacking work tonight, which is good to see.
Well, Jurgen Klinsmann challenged Fabian Johnson to be a little bit more influential in tonight. And he's all over the place. He's tucking inside. He's all out wide on the touchline. He's been good.
Altidore towards Dempsey, too high for him. Away by Rodriguez, who again heads downwards in trying to clear. Not a good idea, and he gave the U.S. the ball back again. It nearly cost Panama a goal in the first half. Barahona Enriquez to spread it wide. This is Paris. Marcos Sanchez. Panama just haven't had that ability to unlock the United States defense that the US have possessed at the other end. Not so far, anyway. This US team giving the big crowd here what they came to see. Eddie Johnson won't be able to quite latch onto that one. Will he get picked, Eddie Johnson, for the World Cup? He missed the cut, didn't he, last time, having been picked in 2006. That's the ultimate heartbreak, something you know all about, Taylor.
Ian, I was having a great night for 74 minutes, and now you go to the 2006 World Cup?
I was hoping you were going to give us an insight.
You're walking home tonight, I'll tell you that right now.
A player's mentality.
No, it's been an up-and-down career for Eddie Johnson, and he was going into the 2006 World Cup at an extreme high, but it's been up and down. He went to Fulham, it hasn't worked out, but he's had a resurgence in his career coming to Seattle. Well, you're buying me dinner, by the way, for bringing that up.
I am. I definitely am. Let's be nice and say you should have been picked.
Should have, could have, would have, Ian.
It's Brad Evans. Now he'll be enjoying tonight. Two goals to the good, looking very good in this group now for the US, who may only need a couple more wins if they hold on to this one here from the last five games. You'd think that ought to be well within the compass of this team. The qualifying story continues next Tuesday on ESPN. The US facing Honduras live from Salt Lake City, Utah. 8:30 Eastern on ESPN, and again available on the Watch ESPN app if that suits you better. Sanchez. Enriquez playing the ball forward. It's a nice turn. Where can Panama take this one? It's Nelson Barahona. Marcos Sanchez, oh, it's very wild and not very handsome. And look at that, the bounce is so odd on this surface that does not go out of play.
That will be used as the commercial for this field.
How did that stay in? Barahona again. Looking for long, hopeful balls in. That should be easy to defend. It was. But DeMarcus Beasley is playing now at left back for the sixth consecutive game.
They've only lost one of those.
Dempsey flattened, but not before he made a nice little layoff to Fabian Johnson. Here's Eddie Johnson again. Every time he gets the ball, the Seattle Sounders fans here, there's a real buzz around the stadium. They so want him to do well, and he has done well with a well-taken goal as well. He's Altidore looking to go to his second World Cup in Brazil. He was there in South Africa playing every game. Didn't score there, but he did win a Man of the Match award in the game against Algeria, the famous game with the heart-stopping finish, that Landon Donovan goal. Eddie Johnson again, the first time layoff. Bradley. Altidore, beautifully done. Dempsey tried to pass it in. Could see the idea.
Well, in the combination play from Josie Altidore and Clint Dempsey, it's because they're not on the same plane. Josie Altidore's high, Clint Dempsey's 5 yards underneath. Now it's so easy for Altidore to take that one touch and then find the run in behind from Dempsey. It's been very good, those two up front.
Final substitution being made by Panama, bringing on the striker Gabriel Torres, who plays in Venezuela for Zamora, and he will replace Amilcar Enriquez. So that's another attacking move, as it has to be, by Panama.
I'm shocked at the 79th minute Jurgen Klinsmann has not made one sub yet. But the amount of players, the key players that are on yellow cards, at some point you have to get them off the field. I mean, you look at the bench, you've got Michael Parker, Sasha Kleshkin, Clarence Goodson, Brad Davis, Edgar Castillo. There's plenty of guys that can come into this game and kill it.
Still no sign of Jurgen Klinsmann thinking along those lines. He's pretty happy with what he's seeing here. Altidore. Oh, and it's beautifully done. Beasley! Oh, he's hit the outside of the post. Nearly his first goal since 2008.
This great combination play in the midfield. What a ball from Michael Bradley, but good recognition from Fabio Johnson. But this is what it's about. Jurgen Klinsmann has asked Josie Altidore to be a complete number nine striker with his back to goal. The last two or three chances have come off of Josie Altidore. Two touch and DeMarcus Beasley unlucky.
I think the USA have been terrific tonight. I really do. They've done the job so well so far. Just a question of closing the show now and pocketing the three valuable points that would put them 2 points clear at the top of this group. And they'd still have a game in hand on Mexico, who have to come yet to Columbus. Well, they've provided the soundtrack, and what a soundtrack. The players have done their bit as well. The excellent attendance here. St. Sounders consistently the club drawing the biggest crowds in Major League Soccer by an average of about 20,000. Now then, is there going to be something else here? Altidore looking to take on Torres, who dithered but then recovered magnificently. Altidore's furious. He could smell another one there. Gabriel Torres. Here he is again, the substitute. Panama have now made all the changes they can. And USA on their way to keeping up their 100% record in this stadium. It's only the fifth time they've played here. And they've won the previous four, and they're on the way to winning this one by the looks of things, barring something very dramatic late on. Sanchez does well. It's Baloy. Now Barahona. Lionel Paris, the right back. Quintero looked so dangerous early on, less so in the second half. He's rather faded.
And Paris has been limited going forward tonight, Ian, because of Fabian Johnson playing so high up on the field.
Big day of World Cup qualifying here. A Harris is going to get a free kick for that. And don't forget, after the end of tonight's game, be sure to go to ESPNFC.com to watch our live post-game show, ESPNFC Boardroom Extra. We'll have a full recap of the match tonight featuring your Twitter questions and comments. Remember, that's hashtag FC Boardroom. Well worth staying around for. All the reaction, all the verdicts, all the comments from our team here, and hopefully an interview or two as well. Spread nicely that time by Tejada. They have kept him pretty quiet, though, the US defenders. The Panama all-time leading scorer.
My Continental Tire analyst corner coming into this game, it was all about answering the call. You get an opportunity because Graham Zuzzi out with yellow card accumulation, Jermaine Jones, these two gentlemen, Eddie Johnson, Jeff Cameron, their stock went up. They were huge players tonight for Jurgen Klinsmann, and we saw it on the second goal with those two.
Both those changes certainly working for Jurgen Klinsmann. He didn't want to meddle with the team too much and move a lot of the pieces in the jigsaw around. Harris just haven't looked like unlocking the US defense too often since the opening 20 minutes or so. Panama towards the back post, though, almost something there for Quintero, is stretching, but he was only a quarter chance really. I think it might be a fair old night in Seattle, you know, and they're going to be out packing out the bars, aren't they? I know you'll be going down to the library later, Taylor. Sanchez. These players have worked very, very hard to try to get Panama back in the game, but tonight the USA have just been too strong, too focused, too disciplined, and also too inventive going forward too. Torres. Well, there's a header wide of the post this time. It's Blackburn who got on the end of that one. Given a free kick, I think, the referee. And Gonzalez doing a lot of talking around him. They want to make sure they keep the clean sheet. Nothing, no late giveaways. Brad Davis coming on this substitution, fueled by Gatorade, to replace Fabian Johnson, who set up the first goal with a quite wonderful ball. Joe Corona is going to come on as well, the player based with Tijuana in the Mexican League. Eddie Johnson's come off to a huge reception from his Seattle fans. An entirely satisfying night for him, one he'll remember. Gabriel Torres, too easy really for Beisler to just get that away. His defenders now just making sure they keep the back door firmly locked. Jurgen Klinsmann wants from this team is consistency, to play like this, be this disciplined every time they go out there. There's no doubt at the moment this team going the right way. Paris easy meet for Tim Howard.
Well, and Ian, you talk about that right way. It's almost like that article in the Sporting News before the Costa Rica game really brought this team together. As you look at how well they've played since that article has come out, we asked Jurgen Klinsmann that this morning. He didn't really talk about that article, but you could kind of sense it from him.
Just to recap, that was the story which suggested there might be divisions in the camp, quoted a few anonymous sources, quite a lot of them. Yeah, I felt that at the time, that it just brought things out into the open, cleared the air a bit, maybe brought on a siege mentality.
Well, and a couple things have changed. He's now telling his team earlier what the lineup is. He's learned a little bit from it as well. But I think it'd be a mistake to say that that article didn't bring this team closer together.
Sanchez to play this one in. They're just hoping, really, Panama just planting balls in there, rather run out of ideas. Would be a heartbreaker for Panama again with this team, a useful team that they've got, that started this group well, if they didn't make it again to the World Cup finals. I'm sure one of these days they will.
It doesn't get any easier, does it?
They've got a lot of away games left. Not a good night, really, for them, with Honduras winning 2-0 against Jamaica. Pendulum's just swung it against them a bit. Gabriel Torres again. Nearly found the right ball for Barahona. Bradley. Green picks a really good ball for Altidore. He's doing so much running into the channel. This is a really fine game tonight. Corona joining in. Look at this, good movement here. Beasley, he's already hit the post. Corona thought about the shot for a moment, ran out of room. Looks like we're going to see Stuart Holden here after his 2 years of